नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंक्रीमेंट एंड डिक्रीमेंट ऑपरेटर. सो प्लस प्लस एंड माइनस माइनस. सो प्लस प्लस इंडिकेट्स इंक्रीमेंट एंड माइनस माइनस इंडिकेट डिक्रीमेंट. द इंक्रीमेंट एंड डिक्रीमेंट ऑपरेटर्स आर यूनरी ऑपरेटर्स एज दे रिक्वायर ओनली वन ऑपरेंड. द इंक्रीमेंट ऑपरेटर प्लस प्लस इंक्रीज द वैल्यू स्टोर्ड इन ए वेरिएबल बाय वन and the decrement operator will decrease the value by 1. Here consider the value, it is given here. So value here it is given a as 10. So here if it is writing now a plus plus means a plus 1 which becomes 11, and decrement operator a minus minus means a minus 1. Suppose I take a value a equal to 5, and then what will be a plus plus, then you have to write a plus plus is equal to what, a plus 1, and a value is 5 plus 1, that's why it is 6. Okay, so it may be this may be change also, b it may be c equal to 10, any number. So if I write C plus plus, then 10 plus 1, that is C plus 1. Understood? So same thing goes with the minus also. So if I write C minus minus, then C minus 1, C value is 10, minus 1, it is 9. Okay? So this is how you will use this increment and decrement operators. Okay. Comparison operators. Relational operators are used to compare two expressions. The result of a relational operator is a Boolean value that can be either true or false. So when you compare comparison operator, you will get either true or false. Okay, so the comparison operator used in JavaScript are given below in table 6.5. So these are the comparison operators. So here when you will be using these things, you will get result either true or either false. So you will get only two output. So you can see here a is 5 and b is 10. So when you use these expressions, you have to take a is 5 and b is 10. So a is 5 is equal to b, is it? So a is 5 and b is 10, so it is not equal, so that's why the result is false. So not equal to, so a is not equal to b, this expression is called not equal to. So a is not equal to b, it is true. So here true. Greater than, smaller than, you know. Greater than or equal to, so here it is neither greater than, a is neither greater than nor equal to, so the result is false. But here it is smaller than equal to, so it is not equal to but it is smaller than, that's why it is true. So this is how comparison operators are used. Logical operators. JavaScript supports logical operators and, or, and not. So these are the three logical operators supported in JavaScript. They are used with one or more relational expression and the result is either true or false. So here also the result is either true or false. False, true. Okay, so here also consider the value is given here a as 5 and b as 10. So here if you see in the table, and operator results in true if both the condition are true, otherwise it is false. So here it is given, two expressions are given, a is not equal to b and a is greater than equal to b, so both the conditions are false. Okay, so that's why the result is false. Here or, so when you use or operator, one condition if it is true, then the output is true. So if the both conditions are false, then the result is false. So any one, if it is correct, then the output is true. So now if you can see here, A is not equal to B, and here it is given A is smaller than equal to B. So here both the conditions are true, I think it's true. Okay, so one condition should be true. And not, with not operator, if the condition is true, the result is false, and if the condition is false, the result is true. So A is not greater than, this sign is given here, that means not. Okay, so A is not greater than B. So this symbol is given, that means whatever written inside is not, okay, so A is not greater than B, that is true. If you see, A is not greater than B, B is greater, so this condition is true. Hope you all are understanding this part. So these are all little you have to go through, these meanings you have to read carefully and you will understand. So compound assignment operators, in order to perform an operation with the value currently stored in a variable and store the resulting value in the same variable, compound assignment operators are used. So here this sentences you read to understand. Okay, the following is the compound assignment operator supported by JavaScript. So there is a table after this page, next page there is a table. So in that table the value is taken as A as 5 and C as 15. So let us see how the values are evaluated there. So this is the operator. Now what does this operator do? It adds the right side operand to the left side operand and assign the result to the left side operand. Okay, so it adds the right side operand. Right side means A here. Whatever value is given in C will be added to A. Clear? So A value is 5 and C value is 15. So 15 is added to 5. Okay? And then you get the result. Clear? So in same way you have multiplication part. So multiplication also you read it. Same thing happens, the right side operand, right side operand. So in modulus also it is done in the same way. Now if you can see here, because the remainder will be 0, so the answer is 0 here. Okay, so everywhere if you see the value or the right side operand with the left side operand and assign the result to the left side operand. So in each case the calculation is done in the same way. Okay, so this one if you understand, this all are also very easy, you will understand. Next is conditional operator. The conditional operator evaluates an expression and returns the value written after question mark if the condition is evaluated true. So whatever written after question mark is evaluated if the condition is true. So after question mark, what is that? True. So in this condition, if the condition is true, then the answer will be displayed after question mark. And if the condition is false, the answer will be displayed whatever written after colon. Okay. So after this, whatever you have written. So in this example, you will understand. You see, here variable age and result is taken. Age is 20. Result, age is greater than 18. So if age is greater than 18, you are over 18, message will displayed. Then you have colon, and if you are writing age less than 18, so you will get the output this one. So this one I will show you in a video I will upload, and then you can see the video, you will understand. Okay, conditional operator means like giving condition. Here the explanation is given, you just read it, you will understand. Okay. What is prompt dialog box and how it is used in JavaScript? So the prompt dialog box is used when you want the input from the user. The general format is age equal to prompt, enter your age and you have to write 0. So now what does this do? So if you see down this part, you read, it is not this one, no, it is just explanation. So I am explaining, I am not reading out this part, I am just explaining you whatever is written here, those things only. So if you use prompt, what happens? Age equal to prompt, so it will show you like this. Now in this way you will get a script prompt, enter your age. So if you remember, if you see, enter your age is written here, so you will get a output, enter your age. So you will write your age here and then you press OK, and then OK, so here 20 is given, and when you press OK you will get a output here, you are over 18. OK, so whatever message you write you will get here, you will, the message will be displayed in this way. So here the condition is given now. So here age equal to prompt, enter your age. So here, see, earlier what happened in the earlier JavaScript notepad, here the age was already given, age equal to 20, but in this case we are not giving age equal to, we are giving prompt dialog box. So this dialog box will appear and then the user will input. So what is the definition of prompt dialog box? Is used when you want the input from the user. So here when you are using age equal to prompt, so there will be a prompt dialog box, the user will give input and he will get a output. Okay, so this video also I will upload very soon, you can see the video.